Now, it's time for one of our own, an IFA, to come out and speak to us about what business model he's adopting and for us to learn from our own individual practices. And that's really where it is, and I'm happy to welcome. Because it's an IFA, I don't want to get into the guessing game. It's more difficult. So I'm going to go straight into the aspect. Deepesh Mehta is the IFA. Please come up, Deepesh. Quickly put in perspective, Deepesh is a graduate in management and a certified financial planner, having expertise in mutual funds, fixed income portfolio, and personal finance risk management. He founded Grow Wealth in 2007. He's based out of Bangalore and has been helping families build wealth and achieve long-term wealth objectives. He's going to talk to us about a very important topic that is close to our heart, and as some of the previous speakers have said, that you don't need to bother about your growth as long as your client grows. You know, that's really a very powerful statement. So he's going to talk to us about how clients grew with me, and that's Deepesh. Over to you, Deepesh.
And before you start your presentation, may I request Mr. Shanmugam to kindly come on to the stage and honor Mr. Deepesh with a shawl. And as the presentation is being done, can we all put our hands together? And you're warm welcome to Mr. Deepesh.
Thank you. I'll just take 10 minutes and I'll just tell you what different things that we did, what innovation that we did, so that we gain the trust of our clients. Let me just start off with this. So, when you had an engineer, he was for 4 years of graduation, you had a doctor for 5 years of graduation, you had an architect for 5 years. We as financial advisors, what do we do? How do we become an IFA? You just pass an IFA exam and become an IFA. Right? But we need to understand that just passing an IFA exam doesn't make history for the client. Hence, what I recommend is, we need to read our Bible well. With this, I have classified 3 sets of books which we need to learn and make sure that we carry these practices to our clients. The first set is about investment management. It's about asset allocation and other details, investment management details, and hence I have read this Intelligent Investment from Benjamin Graham, which is a century year old book. And then the second one is Simple Wealth and Inevitable Wealth. And on the behavioral finance side, the most important part, Nick Murray and the title of Behavioral Investing by James Montier. And on practice management, most of us forget this. We really understand what asset allocation we need to do our kind, but we don't understand what are the kind of templates and tools that we need to have for our business. Hence, I as a financial advisor, I recommend you to read these books. Let's move on. I've been to Mumbai, and there's a hotel, A. Ramanai Kutti. It was founded in 1942. What? Can you read this? The owner, the board says that owner of the hotel eats here. This drew an inspiration for me. The owner was very upfront and clear that may the khata or eat here. Now let me question you, if you sell a mutual fund to a client, does he have a kind of a question saying that is he investing in a bank deposit and selling a debt fund to me? Client has this question in his mind. So what did we do? We took a bold step and I disclosed my entire family's ECAS to my clients. Without second thought, we just told our client, this is my father's investment, this is my mother's investment, this is my investment, my wife's investment. We showed the entire investment scheme of funds that we had for our clients. This built and trust. Second thing, what did we do? We wrote a mail to clients on October 1st, 2016, that how much commission we earned from your investments. Look at this. For one client, we mentioned that we earned a commission of 46,000 rupees in the last 6 months, from April 2016 to September 2016. For another client, we wrote an email saying that we earned a commission of 74,500. Not only that, we also mentioned that these are the costs that we incur by doing a business. SEBI coming and saying that your distributors are earning this much of commission, we made sure that we tell our clients that we come out. The client trusted us. All our clients. Even the smallest client, whom we earned about 5,000 rupees annually, even those clients we made this clear. And this is a screenshot I've taken from my email. The third thing that we did was, we fired all those clients who were demotivating us. There was a lady who earned 14% CAGR last 2 years, and she was not happy. She thought, frankly, Prima Fund has done well, but ICICI Focus Blue Chip has not done well. Why didn't you not recommend me, frankly, in the Prima Fund for my entire portfolio? She kept on questioning these things. We were to make that end of our professional relationship, we don't need anything from you, that's all. Take those bold decisions with your clients. You will filter out all the unwanted clients and you will be having cream set of clients. These cream set of clients will take you to the next level. Next, spend half day of your time, we spend half day of our time on research. 6 days a week when you work, half day of that week, you need to spend your time on research. All your mails from Cafe Mitchell, Wealth Forum and other blogs, you need to slot it down, we slot it down in a different folder. And in that half day, we just read the entire stuff which we wanted to learn. And we don't depend on free website for research. We do our own proprietary research. Please look at this. This is our own proprietary research. You can see we have large cap, mid cap, multi cap, and different sort of funds. We do our own research. You can see this. For example, we have taken this accrual funds, Vedasan and corporate bond fund, what is the exit load, modified duration, ITM expense ratio, everything we have here. If a client asks, how can I trust that you are giving a right fund to me, we say that we have proprietary data. We did this. Attend maximum seminars, training, self-development programs as possible. Other than this, there is no other way of learning practically. You need to do this. This is required irrespective of whatever AUM you have, 2 crore, 20 crore, 200 crore, 500 crore. You need to attend this. In the year 2016, I attended about 42 programs. We think that attending a program is a waste, but no, it is adding a value. And make sure along with you, your team member also attend those trainings. Apart from the training, we also do IFAs. Some speaker mentioned that you need to do IFAs for younger children. We have done IFAs for these college students. We also attended this kind of trainings. I also give speech. You need this. These are all the ingredients for your success. Be creative in your output by presenting to your clients and team members. We use this something called as a mind map, which you've been using for the last 3 years. So one example, this mind map, this is about business trip, this is actual mind map. Once you look at this, and mind map is a picture which tells you that in a single feather, what exactly are your weak points and where you need to work on. For example, for business development, I need to work on newsletters, or I need to change my status of my company global to an LLP and with an RIA status, I need to do that. I need to do addition of few more products like art, hedge funds, IPO. I know where I am lacking. The one which I have done, I just put a tick. Keep prospecting all the time. You are like a doctor. The more patients you see, the more money you make. Block every time, every day, every week to prospect. You need to keep on prospecting. Somebody mentioned in the morning saying that if you have over 500 clients, half of them will die after 20 years. What will you do then? You need to keep on prospecting. Make prospecting for habit. Remember, the more time you spend prospecting this year, the more you will grow next year. Don't be a permanent bull by selling only equities. Have hedge funds in your portfolio, clients' portfolio. Sell PMS alternative funds. Other structure products to HNI. HNI is get board after 2 crores. if HNA has 10 crore and if you recommend him as the mutual fund portfolio of 10 crore, he doesn't need you. He needs different exotic products. You need to have those in your portfolio. Empanel with tax-free bond dealers, HNA needs this. Online bill generation, yes, estate planning, help banks to get loans. Tie-up with attorneys and other hired professionals. Basically, you need to develop from a Kali Pili taxi to an online report. Get value, give valuation to clients, not just investment advice related to mutual fund. Very important. In the recent last 2 months, all the banks have reduced their interest rates. What did we do? We, in our client list, we found out those clients who had housing loans. We wrote a mail to the clients saying that you have a housing loan, please switch it to MCLR rates by paying 0.5%. And you'll be saving 1.5% on your interest rates. The client appreciated and many converted this. Next, what did we do? We found whichever clients had business. We sent them mail saying that how you have to register for trademarks. People who were having businesses, they actually need all the stuffs. They don't need only investment advice. Even a script box or any other online portal gives them investment advice. They don't need us. You need to do some different things to keep clients with you. Use stories in communication that works well. What did we do? We took the client's son's birthday on this date, 4th March 1985. Sensex was 354. Then we took client's son's education 22 years after that, 26 to 2007, Sensex was 13649. We found the CAGR was 18%. We told why you need to think long term. Because in the long run, market gives this much kind of return. Hence, you need to put in this kind of equity products. You need to tell these kind of stories. Unless you don't tell a story, the client will not able to understand what you're trying to communicate. You need to have a process for adhere to IFA guidelines, norms and intermediaries. With all our clients, we have an engagement letter signed. That this is what I will be offering to you, this is what I will not be doing for you. You need to understand, with a client, you need to ask his benchmark portfolio returns. Client needs 8%, you give him an 18% product, it doesn't do well. Client needs 15% product, you sell a debt fund, doesn't do well. You need to ask his benchmark portfolio and then design the portfolio accordingly. Look good, trust smart. I have had an image consultant. An image consultant tells you how you need to dress with HNS, how you need to dress when you go to these kind of programs, how you need to dress. Coming here, I just asked my image consultant, I'm going to this program, what I need to dress. She told me you need to have a lighter trouser and a darker coat. This matters. Have a checklist for your business. We carry this kind of checklist. I'll tell you how this checklist business came. When you actually board a flight, there are about 800 checklists a pilot undergoes. Before that checklist is not ticked, the flight cannot fly. Same kind of checklist you need to have in your business. And this will be published, this was published in web forum also. Like before boarding a client, what you need to do. During the client meet, what you need to do. After the client meet, what you need to do. This kind of checklist, you and me, when we get an application form from a client, my staff have the checklist. Unless and until the checklist is not cleared, the application form doesn't go from my office to CAPS. And last, have faith in our business. Remember, this is a business, if you stay long, you will die a Mercedes. To meet a client, you will die a Mercedes. Thank you so much.
Round of applause, yeah. Deepesh, I've been 20 years in this business, and there are at least 3 ideas from your presentation which I thought were very, very relevant for me to take away from today. And thank you so much. I think it's been a great presentation. Wonderful show.
Definitely, it's not easy being the last speaker of a day and yet being so charismatic. One more time for me, we put our hands together for Deepesh. And may I request Mr. Anna Malay from Madurai to come. kindly come on to the stage and present a memento and a gift to Mr. Deepesh as a token of our love.
Unless you don't do this, attending this kind of seminars will not help you.